Walt Disney's Disneyland, the story of Dumbo.
Unlike today, when Walt Disney was creating Disneyland, he didn't have a large library of characters to choose from when designing attractions for his park. Naturally, Dumbo, one of his most successful films at the time, and a personal favorite of Walt's, would be represented in his new park. Ironically enough, the original design of the attraction would not feature Dumbo at all. The initial plan had guests riding in 10 pink elephants, from the alcohol-induced Elephants on Parade scene from the movie. Thankfully, Mr. Disney objected to this idea and ordered the elephants to be painted gray instead. Unfortunately, Dumbo would still be plagued by problems and would open 1 month after Disneyland's grand opening. The original Dumbo cars were delivered just 3 weeks before Disneyland's opening. Each car weighed 700 pounds, and they were too heavy for the mechanical supports, which caused the ride to break down before the park even opened. Dumbo finally opened on August 16, 1955. The original Dumbo had hinged ears that were supposed to flap, but failed due to a number of mechanical problems. The ears remained stationary until the mid-1960s when Dumbo received new cars, this time with no movable ears. Dumbo is one of the most iconic Disney attractions and was an opening day attraction for the Magic Kingdom, Tokyo Disneyland, Disneyland Paris, Hong Kong Disneyland, and Shanghai Disneyland. With the exception of Shanghai, where Dumbo is in Gardens of Imagination, every other Dumbo attraction is located within Fantasyland. The Magic Kingdom's original Dumbo did not have the water feature like its Disneyland counterparts. This was due to the attraction's location. The park's utilidors ran directly below the attraction, preventing the installation of water pipes. In 1983, as part of Fantasyland's major remodeling, Disneyland moved Dumbo to the former Skull Rock location. The attraction's mechanism was completely rebuilt and was given a new look, although it still only featured 10 elephants. The ride suffered from two minor accidents. In 1989, one of the elephants partially detached from its support arm, and in 1990, one of the support arms completely collapsed. No major injuries were reported, but Dumbo remained closed until Disney came up with a plan. Michael Eisner, CEO at the time, decided to replace Disneyland's ride with the already built Dumbo attraction for Disneyland Paris, since the European park was still years away from opening. This new version, which was intended for Paris, featured 16 elephants instead of 10, improving the capacity of the attraction. Florida's version received the new 16-elephant Dumbo in 1993. In 2011, Disney announced the new Fantasyland expansion at the Magic Kingdom, which would open in phases. The first phase to open was Storybook Circus, where not one, but two Dumbos would operate side by side. The new Dueling Dumbo not only increased capacity, but also opened with a new indoor interactive queue. This new version of Dumbo also gave Florida the water feature it previously lacked. In 2018, the queue for Dumbo at Disneyland was expanded and is now covered with new shade structures. It also received a new color scheme. In 2005, celebrating Disneyland's 50th anniversary, the park donated one of the ride's elephants to the Smithsonian National Museum of American History, cementing its status as an icon of American pop culture. For a ride that had a shaky start, Dumbo rose above its challenges and continues to soar and entertain guests all over the world.